Alright, this is a very solid hand. I'm on the draw here, and yeah, just running Tithe Drinker, hopefully into Cellar of Songbirds. Hopefully not having an opponent with Mortars. Every time one of my opponents plays a black or a red land, I'm just going to assume that they have Mizzy Mortars in their deck until I'm proven otherwise. And let's see. Scar Guildmage, not bad. Not bad. Alright. Getting their Tithe Drinker. Do I trade with Scarred Guildmage? It's actually a close one, since Scarred Guildmage is also pretty good. Most 2-drops you would just not trade Tithe Drinker for. But on the other hand, I also have Swift Justice, and Swift Justice means I can probably pick off the Guildmage at some point. My opponent's not going to offer the trade, I don't think. Not after playing a battalion creature. Right, what do I do now? If I drew a 2-drop, I would definitely just attack with the Tithe Drinker. But since I didn't, I think I just play Cellar of Songbirds. I think makes it so my opponent can't attack all that well. I guess he can animate a land and hit with all three, but then I get to eat the Scar Guildmage for basically free, trading just a cellar for it and keeping a bird. So that's probably not happening. And the colors, children, the colors. Look at all these. Alright, powerful 4-drop. See, these are the decks that I think the 2-color decks are supposed to be good against. Alright, I'll take it. I mean, I could trade a Tithe Drinker for it, but I don't think I want to do that. The Extort part is actually going to be very good here soon, so... Alright, let's not attack with the Tithe Drinker. Let's just play a Zurichi Tiger. Starting to get things going. And... I guess I'll hit with the bird. That seems fine. Since I have the Cellar to chip in against the Zurichi Tiger, the Scarred Guildmage isn't coming in anyway. And if a land gets animated and I get attacked for a bunch, I can just double block the Tiger with a Cellar and Tiger, trading a Cellar for the Tiger, which is a pretty good deal. If just the Warmind comes in, I'll just throw the Tiger in the way. I guess Balustrade Spy might have been better, but I thought that playing Tiger, the next turn I have the option of playing Keening Apparition and using the Tiger, plus keeping Swift Justice up, could be good. I also think I'm more likely to want to just be gaining life off Tiger here than smashing with Balustrade Spy. And if I play Spy and I don't extort, I can't leave Swift Justice up, and it's suspicious and all those things. If I do leave it up. So, opponent's only on 3 cards in hand. Presumably splashing black cards at this point, since looks like just Naya... Tiger and Scarred Guildmage are not often in the same deck. They're not really splash cards, either of them, so... I'm assuming this is Naya with maybe some black card. Oh, I see. A combat trick. Alright. Well, I have a Zurichi Tiger that I don't care that much about. I guess I can just block the Scarred Guildmage with the Tiger and let my opponent cast something. Hopefully it's not Profit Loss. That would be kind of a beating. I mean, this is going to draw a trick, but I think that's fine. Swift Justice doesn't usually trump very many tricks anyway, so I'd rather just get this out of the way. And, next turn play some guys. We'll find out what this trick is in a second here. I mean, it's got to be something, right? Boros Charm? Indestructible? Okay. That's actually very good for me. That doesn't really bother me at all, unless something else has a follow-up. Yeah. Treating a Boros Charm to deal basically, like, a couple extra damage is fine. I mean, that's always an option on Boros Charm. Ooh, speaking of Boros, now I get to just get in there with a bunch of things. Yeah, this seems good. And I get to gain life off the Tithe Drinker, and then I get to, I think, play the Boros Mastiff and extort. And then leave up Swift Justice, and then I can block with a Tiger as well as possibly Mastiff, and possibly use a Tiger instead of doing Swift Justice. Again, I think not extorting is kind of a giveaway, and it's not... It's not for sure that I'm even going to want to use Swift Justice here. Yeah, I like the position I'm in. And also the fact that my opponent made that attack last turn gives me some degree of confidence that my opponent's not planning everything out insanely well. I guess the Boros Charm wasn't that bad just because it was kind of a gimme. If I made a bunch of blocks, it could just blow me out. But the way it turned out, it was pretty favorable for me. So another exchange or two like that and things will be going pretty well. Also, I'm ahead on life now because Tithe Drinker's pretty nice. Alright, are the troops coming in? I can imagine that they might not, especially if there's no better trick than Boros Charm lurking in my opponent's hand. Alright. Now I have to worry about things like getting busy and mortared. Especially since my attacks are all of a sudden not that great. Yeah, I don't really want to get into the Swift Justice thing, especially since with Scarred Guildmage out, my opponent can just make a creature. So I'm going to do this, and then I'm going to play Balustrade by leaving Swift Justice up and extorting. Since I think I'd rather just deal the extra damage than gain 2 life here. Since I'm more on the aggressive now. Boom. Alright. Milling my opponent. They could have scavenge cards, but I wouldn't mind taking a look at what my opponent's got going here. Plus I have Grizzly Spectacle. Maybe I can mill my opponent out. I mean, in game one, I think the information is kind of the tiebreaker, especially since the Naya deck is not likely to have that many scavenge cards. Whereas maybe later. Alright, well, I'm glad I milled the Indrix, so there. Alright, I've looked at the cards. So opponent goes up to 14 off Zurichi Tiger. Didn't play anything this turn, including a land, which is somewhat suspicious. I have a 3 in the air clock. Maybe I will have to use a Swift Justice, actually, since getting in for 3 against a Zurichi Tiger is kind of bad. I'm not, like, assuming my opponent has mortars, but I would like to close out the game before I find out. Especially against a 4-color deck that didn't play their 6th land. Very easy for powerful cards just to be lurking there. But attacks are so bad here. I get multiple blocks that I would have to use Swift Justice on. So maybe because I have the extort card, I just chill and hit for 3. Ooh, I guess the opponent's not gating him up to this turn either. Alright, let's just play Boros Mastiff, extort, and leave up Swift Justice plus Zurichi Tiger here. I don't want to play Keening Banshee and tap out to extort. Or Keening Apparition, and keeping this in hand could be good too in case, you know, some giant enchantment comes out that my opponent's counting on keeping around. But I guess that's an argument for having it in play also, because that way Armadillo Cloak or whatever gets nipped in the bud. Alright. Am I getting slain this turn? Nope. Well, this isn't going too poorly, but again, not. I'm feeling a little nervous. We'll see what ends up happening. Ooh, there we go. My finisher has arrived. Yeah, I guess I just hit for 3 and then play Nav Squad Commandos. And I think I can extort here. Ooh, War Leader's Helix. So this is the person I'm passing to, which makes it much more likely that they have mortars. Ugh, I did not want to see that. Alright. I mean, I assume War Leader's Helix went second, but I guess I don't know for sure. I got the late call to Conclave too. Alright. Looks like we are officially on more of a clock. Well, at this point, it might be worth slamming with a Nav Squad and like 2 Mastiffs and like a Cellar and a Bird Token or something. Maybe not the Cellar, maybe just the 2 Mastiffs and the Nav Squad and hope things work out. I guess we'll see. So yeah, Mizzium Mortars. Probably just sitting on Mizzium Mortars. And they got a really late Sluiceway Scorpion, though that's not a very common splash card. I really would like something a little better. That helps. I mean, I can attack with the Nav Squad and then Swift Justice to kill the Sluiceway Scorpion. That's probably fine. Problem is if I attack with everything else, all these guys block those and that just does not work out. Oh, that was horrendous, I think. Yeah, I basically missed on a point of extort here. Since used to not playing my spells pre-combat, but obviously I'm going to play Syndic, and I'm going to want to extort off the Syndic, then extort a double off the Swift Justice, so. Well, that was unfortunate. At least I'm at a lot of life. Alright, and even though my opponent could easily have mortars, I'm still just going to run out more creatures here. I don't think mortars is going to get me so badly that I don't win the game by not playing more things. Hopefully I don't lose the game by 1 either, because that would be unfortunate. No mountain, no mountain, no mountain. Well, if I pass to Mizzium Mortars and War Leader's Helix to this person and they end up with Sluiceway Scorpion and Call a Conclave in their deck, I take no responsibility for that. Okay, Drudge Beetle, I accept. I have no other combat tricks. I guess I've got a Grizzly Spectacle, which could be good. I'm trying to think of things that would let me just smash with a bunch of creatures. This makes it even less likely now that He's making a giant Skarga Guildmage. Opponent is on 8 though. Let's see. So if I drain opponent to 7, it's 5 blockers and I have 8 attackers. So that still doesn't really work out for me. Next turn it works out fairly well, assuming I don't get Mortar's Doubt. So I think I drain opponent down to 7. Double Extort. And then hit in the air down to 6. And then next turn I get to attack with everything. So I don't want to attack this turn, right? Because the five guy, or the three guys that get through deal 5 damage, 4 damage even. So yeah. Alright. Next turn it is. Next turn might be lethal, depending on what happens here. And no mountain. Alright, as long as mountain doesn't get slammed. How do the trades work out for me? Nav Squad gets chumped probably by Drudge Beetle. And then these four things eat Syndic, 2 Mastiffs, and a Tithe Drinker. And then I get to hit for 6, put my opponent to 0, but that requires my opponent to tap out, not be able to use Tiger or Guildmage, all without affecting the board. Seems fairly unlikely. Ooh, unleash this and we could have it. Alright. That means if I do draw like a Grizzly Spectacle or something, I do win, right? So, does that actually win? Puts my opponent to 4, and then 6 blockers. So 3 cards get through, so yeah, I do actually win here. Well, despite the fact that the 1-point drain I missed almost mattered a lot. And did I also not use Zerichi Tiger because I was talking? Yeah, probably. I think this works, right? 6 blockers, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then 4. And that should do it. Alright, well, I guess I get to gain some life too. I wish I had a Rootborn Defenses deciding against Mizzium Mortars. I wonder what I could do. I'll have to take a look at my sideboard and see if there's anything. Probably not a whole lot is my guess, but I could side in Mind Rot. That's actually not too bad when you're stuck on lands hoping to draw the 6 and I just, you know, Mind Rot your last 2 cards, though I guess that takes a fair amount of circumstances to come together. Yeah, Mizzy Mortar is a nice card. Alright. Block away. And dead. I could draw Death Pact Angel. I guess Death Pact Angel gets around that fairly well. So yeah, I kind of like Mind Rot. Boom. Frenzy Tilling. Riot Gear could be okay because I have all 2/2s. Or Terra Swarm. Like, do I want to take out... Let's look at my curve again. Do I want to take out some of my particularly dorky 2/2s? I really like this thing. This thing would be incredibly excellent. Actually, maybe I take out Zerichi Tiger, put in a Mind Rot, and then take out something for Terra Swarm or something for Riot Gear. I could cut one of my, again, bad 2/2s. My 2/2s actually aren't that bad, but the worst one's probably Tavern Swindler. I think Mastiff's going to be a little better. Put in Riot Gear. This helps me play around Mortars a little bit. I can Riot Gear up one of my 3 toughness creatures. And against an army of 2/3s, I can just start trying to grind through with my 2/2s. I didn't like how blanked all my 2/2s got. I don't think I want to cut more of them, but cutting that one seems pretty reasonable. All right.